the next six preachers that are coming that are going to minister the gospel to us and tell us, woe to those who are at ease in Zion. We're going to start with missionary Crystal Amachukwu. And if there's anything left, we're going to have Elder John Amachukwu. And there ain't going to be a lot left after that. But we have some powerful preachers tonight. Evangelist Shannon Prevost is coming after Elder Amachukwu. Then Elder Justin Mercer is coming after her. Evangelist Yvonne Watford McKinney. And closing us out, the president of the men's department, Elder Anthony Wilson. Clap your hands for them as they come in that order.
Praise the Lord, everybody. The thought that I will leave with you tonight is, oh, Zion, stay with God. Oh, Zion, stay with God. In the book of Amos is proclaiming the impending judgment of God on several nations. When he is talking about the judgment, he speaks to them and says, for three transgressions and for four. This gives us to know that these nations are not just a little wicked, but they are exceedingly wicked. As he proclaims this judgment from Zion, he rounds up the usual suspects. He calls out Damascus, Tyre, Gaza, Edom, Ammon, and Moab. I call these the usual suspects because those of us who know the Old Testament know that these countries are the usual enemies of the people of God. These are the countries that the people of God had to fight against to inherit the land of Canaan. Many of our favorite and most popular Old Testament battles are when God fought on the behalf of the people of God against these very countries. Joshua had to possess the land that these very people possessed. And it's interesting that as long as they stood with God, they prevailed. Isn't that interesting that one nation against six nations prevailed as long as they were with God? I'm here as number six to let you know that you may have the odds of 6-1. Your enemy may be six times stronger than you, six times smarter than you, but if God be for you, he's more than the world against you. And if God is against you, the world for you won't help you. So we see here that Israel and Judah, they are part of the lineup of people who are called out for evil doing. The Bible says that righteousness exalts a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people. If sin can reproach Judah, it can reproach you and I. Sin is a reproach to any people. As Amos is talking and he's calling out the different nations, calling them out for their wickedness, he begins to call out Judah. He begins to call out Jerusalem. He begins to call out Israel. I want to let you know today that the beginning sign of judgment is when God pulls the cloak off for you and calls you out. This is how I know that America is in the midst of judgment. When the Penn State scandal became national headlines, that was judgment. When Eddie Long became national headlines, that was judgment. And since Amos was talking to the people of God, why don't I talk to the people of God here? There is judgment that is even coming to the church. We are where we are right now because the church has lost its position. There are people who are saying that the church must change because the culture is changing. I believe that the culture has only been allowed to change because the church came a long time ago. African Americans, we are divided over the issue of same-sex marriage, but black folks lost their sensitivity to homosexuality a long time ago. We lost it sitting in the black church. We lost it listening to homosexual bishops. We lost it watching Bobby Jones gospel. We lost it looking at Sunday's Best with a grown man in tight pants. So there we are today. We can't take a stand. It breaks my heart to see what this administration is doing, infringing on the religious liberties even of the Catholic Church, twisting their arms for contraceptives and abortion, but all at the same time, less than 5 years ago, the Catholic Church suffered a reproach. And if you suffer a reproach, God will take his hands from round about you. But God is calling us today that we've got to hold up the standard in Zion. God is looking for some people who will stand for God. If you will stand shout yet. Because there is sin in Zion. The enemy is raging. But I'm here to let you know tonight. I'm here to strongly encourage you to stay with God. We serve the God that if you stay with him, he will stay with you. For Psalms 124 says, if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side. But isn't that interesting? He didn't say if it had not been for the fact that we were on his side. It said if it had not been for the fact that he was on our side. I want you to know tonight that the God we serve is a biased God. The God that we serve picks his favorites. If you are one of his people, God is on your side. God will fight for you. Some of you all don't believe me, but I hear God saying, surely I have seen the afflictions, not of the people, but of my people. I have heard their cry because of their taskmasters, and God said, I'm coming down. God is saying tonight, if you stand with me before I let you go down, I'll come down from heaven myself and bring you out. Anybody know it here? We serve a God that won't leave you by yourself. We serve a God. Paul said that Alexander the coppersmith has done me much harm, spoke evil words against me. And what did God do? Paul said, all men forsook me. Nobody stood with me, but the Lord stood by me. I want you to know tonight that God, his eyes are running to and fro in the earth, looking for somebody to show himself strong. Will that person be you? Will that person be you? If God will take a side, you ought to take a side. You might